And Trey Gowdy, member of the House Judiciary and Oversight Committee, is with me live today in Greenville, South Carolina. And thank you for coming back here on America's Newsroom.
It's been reported
that there could be as many as 650,000 emails on Anthony Weiner's computer. If that is true, can you say that the deleted 33,000 on behalf of Hillary Clinton's own server are part of that cache?
No, sir. I don't think anyone can say that. They can tell you what the metadata says, but I don't even think the Bureau agents have read these emails, and I certainly have not.
Have you considered that possibility?
I hope that all records that are considered records will ultimately be made available. But keep in mind, Bill, that we're talking about decisions that Secretary Clinton made years ago that prompted you to even have to ask that question. I want the entire public record to be complete, whether that's classified information or whether it's a benign email about Yemen. These are public records, and the public is entitled to them.
Is a president-elect under an active investigation on behalf of the FBI, is that individual eligible for a security clearance?
I think so, Bill, under the theory that the ultimate security clearance check takes place on November the 8th. The President of the United States does not have to go through a security background check, just like members of Congress and U.S. senators don't have to go through a background check. If the voters elect someone, that is tantamount to having a security clearance.
So if she wins a week from tomorrow, then she will be privy to whatever national secrets are necessary for Commander-in-Chief to know, correct?
Yes, sir.
On Friday, you issued a statement, and you said Director Comey's statement was instructive. What do you mean by that word, instructive?
Well, Bill, there are other ways the head of the FBI can notify Congress that an investigation has reopened. In other words, his explanation was that he was supplementing the record. He had previously said the investigation was closed. He wanted to avoid the problems that Commissioner John Koskinen has now because he did not supplement the record. My point was he thought it was important enough to not just tell Congress that the matter had been reopened, but also tell the public. And I think the reason he did that, Bill, is keep in mind Secretary Clinton and her acolytes for months now have been saying the FBI cleared me. No wrongdoing. The investigation is over. Well, if she were to continue saying that in the week before the election, Director Comey knows that that is not true. So if he knows is not true, then why should the rest of us who are having to decide what to do on November the 8th also not know that that is true?
Alberto Gonzalez, former attorney general, was on earlier today. And what he said was that there's very little with this investigation that is consistent with protocol, suggesting how the Department of Justice operates, how the FBI operates. Is that true, sir?
Bill, unusual and difficult facts make for difficult conclusions. But most of these facts were given us by Secretary Clinton, not by Jim Comey. I mean, I'm sure former Attorney General Gonzalez and former Attorney General Holder will tell you that having Loretta Lynch meet with the spouse of the target of investigation on the tarmac is unusual. I am sure they will both tell you that having the current president prejudge the outcome of this investigation while the investigation was ongoing is unusual. And heavens knows, having the commander-in-chief actively campaigning for someone who is under FBI investigation is unusual. So everything about this is unusual,
What he went on to say is that since the Attorney General, Loretta Lynch, recused herself, that you now have James Comey essentially left to himself to pursue this. That in itself is highly unusual. Has that ever happened before?
Yes, I think it actually has. I think Eric Holder had to recuse himself. Now, Loretta Lynch has a very, very capable top deputy in Sally Yates. So it doesn't go from Loretta Lynch to Jim Comey. There are other people in positions of responsibility in the Department of Justice. It is unusual for an FBI agent to also make charging decisions. The agents make recommendations, and then the prosecutor makes the ultimate decision. So it is unusual, but why are we here, Bill? We're here because Loretta Lynch met with the spouse of the target of the investigation. That's not Comey's fault. That's Loretta Lynch's fault.
Last night, you referred to Senator Harry Reid after he issued a strong statement against the FBI director. You called him a political hack. Do you stand by that today?
Oh, if I can't really use the word I want to use because it would get us in trouble with the FCC. So we'll just go with political hack.
Why is that? Why do you use that phrase today?
It is laughable that Jim Comey committed a violation of the Hatch Act. I actually know what the Hatch Act is. And if the president of the United States actively campaigning on company time for another candidate to be president of the United States is not a violation of the Hatch Act, then how is Jim Comey supplementing the record and telling the truth to Congress a violation of the Hatch Act? Harry Reid knows that this is not a violation of the Hatch Act. This is the same guy that went on the floor of the Senate and said Mitt Romney didn't pay taxes. So he is a political hack, and I would say more than that if I weren't going to get fined by the FCC.
Trey Gowdy from South Carolina today. Sir, thank you. We'll see where it goes from here.
Yes, sir.